Hello guys, and welcome back to the Zain Investing. Today is filled with exciting events, and it appears that someone is concealing something in AMC stock. I want to be the first to share this information with you, because what we are observing is quite alarming. Let's jump right in and get started. I'd like to begin by discussing the current state of the markets, as I believe that's of interest to everyone. An investor or trader must receive this information immediately. First things first. In essence, what's happening today is that the data came out exceptionally well, particularly the ADP employment change. This is currently affecting the markets. The anticipated ADP employment change for the month of June was 228,000 job increases. You added 497,000 positions. This is terrible news for the Fed and for efforts to tighten the employment market. However, the JOLTS job openings, which represent the total number of job openings, are delayed. So the JOLTS job openings are for the month of May. June marks the ADP employment transition, so it is somewhat behind the JOLTS. The number of job openings was 9.8 million. You anticipated approximately 9.9 million. From April to May, you contracted approximately 500,000 jobs or job openings. However, the ISM services PMI came in at 53.9, which is negative. You had anticipated a reading closer to 50. So services are robust. Significantly more positions are being created than anticipated, and job openings are decreasing slightly. Negative impact on what the Fed must do to calm the economy. Employment economy. We had anticipated a larger decline in JOLTS, job openings, and the ADP employment change would not exceed our expectations. This is the reason why markets are falling. This resulted in European equities closing 2.4% lower. Keep in mind that this ADP employment change was released at 8:15 am, or approximately halfway through European trading. Consequently, European equities fell by nearly 2.5%. We observe a significant response to these data. Now, tomorrow will bring with it more comprehensive economic data, and I'd like to discuss that as well. However, this actually examines the yields on two-year bonds. They are deranged, man. Now at 5.4%. Today, they are up approximately 10 basis points. This is the highest yield on a two-year bond that you have ever observed, in this cycle's entirety. This is a five-year chart, and you're currently bursting out to new highs, all-time or infrequent highs. When we last observed this, it was in April of 2006, the date. It's been quite a while. Right. Therefore, this is negative. In addition, the 10-year Treasury yield is breaking out to near new highs for this cycle, rising approximately 12 basis points to 4.06% today. This is a greater disadvantage because the 10-year Treasury determines your mortgage interest rates. It dictates your auto rates, your loan rates. Right, consider the matter carefully. If you are a lender, if you have a large sum of money that you want to lend out in order to earn a return on, then you should consider the following. Well, if a 10-year Treasury bond pays you over 4% and is considered risk-free, what are you going to loan me money for? That I would never be able to repay you. It's significantly riskier, right? You will lend this money for 8%, 10%, or perhaps 6%, or 7% if you're feeling magnanimous. This is a problem, correct? This constrains the economy, which contributes to the Fed's tightening efforts. Today, however, you are witnessing nearly half of a rate hike's worth of tightening. Overall, this is negative for the likelihood of a soft landing, and inflation may remain elevated for a prolonged period of time. The major data will be released tomorrow morning. If the ADP report is any indication, this will be the non-farm payrolls for the month of June. Indeed, your performance exceeds expectations. Currently, an increase of 225,000 jobs is anticipated. You added 339,000 jobs last month. Because of the ADP employment change, we almost anticipate this number to be astronomically high this time around. But we'll see. There's a possibility it won't be as strong as the ADP report. But anything above 250,000 is unlikely to be a huge positive. Right. If 300, 400, or 500,000 jobs are added, it will likely be another red day on the markets, similar to today. Now, it is anticipated that the unemployment rate will return to 3.6%. The previous employment rate increase was from 3.4% to 3.7%, even though you outperformed on the report of non-farm payrolls. Consequently, it is conceivable that the unemployment rate will rise and that non-farm payrolls will increase further. Tomorrow, this information will be the most important to track, and I anticipate another significant market movement. Currently, ANC stock is only down approximately 0.25%. You have essentially traded sideways for an extended period of time. You have not reached a new nadir in quite some time. You have not reached a new peak in an extremely long time. And if you glance at CNBC today, you'll see that the Russell 2000 has fallen 2.2%. The Nasdaq falls 1.17%. The S&P is 1% lower, while the Dow is 1.36% lower. Why is AMC's decline only a quarter? That don't make sense. Right. So, why is this occurring? I believe it's safe to state that the downside of this court proceeding has been priced in. Yesterday, B. Riley Securities predicted that this would be favorable for AMC stock. Perhaps the markets are beginning to anticipate this. That would be my best estimate. Someone is currently concealing something. This appears to be very clear, particularly in the present day. And I say this as a result of the option orders we are observing. Today, a multitude of transactions were executed. No surprises here. They're mostly in place. However, consider the expiration dates for these three characteristics. They expire tomorrow in the literal sense. They cost $9 each. One of these deals is worth $9,500,000. Another transaction is roughly $2 million. And this final transaction is approximately $3 million. So why do they engage in such massive transactions that expire in one day? With, I suppose, countless millions of dollars, potentially to conceal something. If you purchase call options, you can report that your short position has been covered. What is intriguing about this? We should also receive the next dissemination of short interest data in the near future. And will possess more than 1, 2, or 3x its market capitalization in cash in the bank, and hopefully pay off a significant amount of debt as well. So, according to this equation, the stock should rise. We'll see what transpires in the end. Currently, that is all I have for you folks. There is really nothing else occurring during the day. Obviously, we are discontinuing that poor service. China released PMI yesterday. This front is still digesting the news. This earnings season will be a whirlwind for those anticipating the release of tomorrow's data as well as those preparing for earnings. I trust you guys are prepared. Join the trading community if you want to trade with me live every time I make a trade by clicking the link in the description of this video. If you have not yet received complimentary stock from Wibble, or if you have not yet signed up, click the link in the description of this video. Sign up, deposit $1. Receive 15 free securities. It's gratis. It is nearly gratis 99. You know, to get some money for nothing. Therefore, take advantage of this. Give me a few gratis stocks to help support the channel. Enjoy the remainder of your day, and I will see you in the following one.